is my first vlog. Hi, this is BJ. It is Wednesday, February 4th, and I just wanted to give a really quick update of how I'm doing. My weight had been fluctuating on average between 170 and 175, and just a little bit before I had recommitted, it had started fluctuating up to like 179. So now I'm back into the lower ends, like more around 170. So that's pretty good. When I started the raw diet before, it took me a while to see, well, not a while, but it was a couple weeks before I actually lost any weight. And it was a couple weeks before I saw big differences in my blood sugar numbers. So I'm not too worried about that. I've been doing juice every day, a quart of juice. Okay, and as far as raw, I've probably been doing 80 to 90% of raw vegan foods. I want to clarify, I don't identify myself as a raw vegan, but I try to eat mostly raw vegan foods. So I just wanted to make that clear. The benefits. I've got a lot more energy lately. My mood is a lot better. As far as my face, I had showed you last time some of those lumps and bumps I had on my face. And some of them have gone away. They're not as bad as they were before. Something else I'm noticing improvement in that I wasn't expecting is I have this bump under my eye. See, especially when I smile. And I think personally it was a whole lot worse recently, and I think it's getting better. I think it was a lot more obvious when I wasn't smiling. I wanted to point out, see, it's really hard now for me to point out those lumps and bumps. This one here is actually a mole. This was a lot bigger last time when I had pointed out I have like these broken capillaries through here. It was a lot bigger, and that has gone down a lot. Like I said, that's a mole. So anyway, I've got one, two that are still a problem, three, and then of course the spider veins. I have this. I don't know if this will go away. This one's a really bad keratinized one too. But last time I went down, I have one here on the other side. And this side, this one has been a problem for a while. When I did the juice, it went away. So I have one, two, three, four, five. So about five major ones here, and then I still have a scattering around my outer eye. Before I couldn't really count them, there was too many of them. The recipes. A lot of the recipes that I tend to use are slanted towards Mexican or like Native American traditional foods. So you'll find a lot of recipes with that slant. Indigenous cultures, before the Spaniards came here to Southwest, and of course before the settlers came, their way of eating was very similar to the raw food way of eating. They did cook certain things. There were practical reasons. And they did eat meat, but it was at celebrations, at harvest times. It wasn't very often. Their typical meal was usually a gruel and a vegetable, and it was very low fat. And so I think there's a lot to learn from how they ate. So anyway, check that out. I've put chia seed recipes, I'm getting ready to put up a chili con avocado recipe, which is actually pretty good. So come check it out.